series, which is to socialize. To socialize in the city through design. Next. Here, an architect, without much work, just inventing a project by engineering economy in neighborhoods in Rotterdam. The market that also became that almost became obsolete in the south part of Rotterdam, suddenly by means of a kind of curatorial vision of the market, became very popular again. Next. Or this guy, Jan Konings, he invented Hotel Transvaal, next picture, where he found in a neighborhood, where's the ground plan? I don't only see the function. But anyway, this is a kind of neighborhood where he found empty houses, empty lots, where he started small hotels. And this local chain of hotels fueled the vitality of the neighborhood very much, because the artists and the guests of the hotels were going into the neighborhood and recharged that area very much. Next. I will skip a couple of examples. Next. So what I'm trying to point out here is that architecture, that design, of course, can still be seen as the production of images. It still can be seen as the production of objects in space. And of course, as architects and as designers, you can confine yourself, even shackle yourself, to only that scale. But my proposition is, think beyond the image. Think beyond the object. And think about the performativity of design. Think about how architecture can make a difference. Next. To create a closer and cleaner food production. Next. To create environments where exercise is nice to do, which is more accessible and with less pollution. Next. An energy system which is self-sufficient and more economical. No mortgage on the future of our children. Next. An architecture that finds space where nobody expects it. Next. An architecture that helps people to synchronize and to enjoy quality time. Next. An architecture that enables people to find each other, to organize encounters, to foster understanding and dialogue. Next. An architecture that helps establish a society to think in the long term and to think sustainably. Like here in Bhutan, not too quickly, must. In Bhutan, which no longer has a gross national product, which is an economical category, but has a gross happiness product, which is a much more comprehensive notion of what the society is all about. The gross national happiness. Right, well, that's my proposition to you. I think it's all about strategies. It's all about the courage to redefine what you are doing and to escape the repetitive patterns of the professions. And I think what can be done by architects, it can also be done by politicians, it can also be done by clients, by investors, by developers, by housing corporations. And that's what we exactly need, right? We need this kind of openness, this ability to probe new trajectories, new strategies, which may help us to find each other more quickly and more beneficially. So I had also a few remarks about what I thought about redefining the issues here, but I will save them for the debate, because there is something about redefining exactly what the issue is here, you know, to find this common ground for which it might be helpful. So I leave it here. Thank you for your attention.
Thank you very much for your contribution. To Ole Bauman, Mrs. Vilma Earth. And also I would like to invite Nubio Pacheco Sokoli, the Director of Urban Planning Department, to join the panel. And Valdeto Swani, who is President of the Association of Architects of Kosovo, who is also a member of this panel, please. and as well as Senat Halite, who is representing you, our students of architecture and the virtual network of architecture. Mr. Kai Buckler and I will try to moderate the debate. In the meantime, so